right, so today we're gonna check out some Passport Bro videos, man, and what some girls gotta say about the Passport Bros, man. All right, so anyways, let's get into the damn video.
Dear Passport Boys, dear Passport Bros, stop calling yourself Passport Boys and Passport Bros. Are you going to the Philippines to look for a Filipina queen or what?
Yeah.
So stop calling yourself Passport Boys and Passport Bros.
What are we?
Start calling yourself Passport Kings.
Yes, sir!
You are a Passport
King.
Now, if you're going to the Philippines to just puck around, pull around, screw around as many women as you want,
woo!
Then call yourself Passport Bros and Passport Boys. Otherwise, if you want to go to the Philippines to look for a Filipina queen and she will treat you like a king, then you better start calling yourself
Passport Kings. I like that.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I definitely understood that one, ma'am. Ma'am, we definitely understood that and definitely going to be calling ourselves Passport Kings from now on.
Tell him. So, can you cook? Can you cook?
Yes. I can cook. I can clean.
Yeah, see, this is why I came to Thailand to
find
a traditional woman.
See, yes, sir.
In the United States, women don't cook and clean.
No.
All they do is complain. That's why I got my passport, and I've left the United States to come seek a wife to have a traditional relationship. So
my boy seemed like he's having a good time. He's loving it, and this is why the Passport Bros are winning. And at the end of the day, I can't see this thing slowing down. Honestly, can't.
These are my thoughts on the Passport Bros situation. Me as a foreign man myself that have been to many different countries, I noticed the difference how foreign women treat their men compared to how American women treat them. And I'm not going to bash American women, but we all can agree that American society promotes hookup culture.
Yep.
Promotes infidelity.
I'll agree with that, sir. 100%.
Promotes respect. And that's both sides of the coin. Men and women do not have traditional values. The type of man that I am, when my woman gets pregnant, I'm going to take care of everything. I wanted to stay at home. I wanted to relax.
Yep.
I wanted to chill. And some women are cool with that. Some women are not. Typically, foreign women with traditional values are okay with that. You really don't have to shit on another person's preference. Trust me, if I want to start a family and I want to get married, 9 times out of 10, I'm not going to Jessica. I'm going to go talk to Maria.
Maria!
It may vary.
Maria. Yeah, 9 out of 10, but then I'm going to Maria as well. Maria is the girl for me, okay? I'm going to look for Maria, not Jessica, all right?
What do you think of women in other cultures and how they treat their men?
They can't really, like, do what they want to as far as going outside, having fun and stuff in other cultures as much as they can in America.
You think women in foreign lands can't go outside? What are you, chained to the house, to the kitchen sink, and just wash dishes and prep meals?
Right?
Those women have far more freedom than you do. Don't tell them that little secret, though. We're too busy with the Fembot Kool-Aid over here.
Guys, let's get our passports, bro. They don't appreciate us here.
Oh my God.
An opportunity for them to go in search of spouses who they feel are going to be more subservient to them and do what they want, basically some sort of indentured servitude.
It's easier for these men to go overseas, get one of these victims.
A lot of these passport bros are exploiting a power imbalance economically.
Y'all are taking advantage of these women.
No.
If you feel that you need to go to Antarctica to marry a polar bear.
But they're still doing the, oh, we're just going to leave and go to another country and find women. Or you're going to die alone. Good luck dying alone with your cats.
Get a polar bear.
Yeah, it is much easier for these passport bros to go to other countries and exploit younger, more impressionable, less educated or uneducated.
God. I hate watching these videos, man.
In poverty.
You know why? Because we don't care. Look, we don't care.
You don't care, but yet you're making these posts.
Guys, let's get our passports.
They don't care, but yet they're making all these damn posts. If you don't care, why are you making posts? Just let it be. Let it be. And the thing that annoys me the most is, like, white guys been doing this for years, okay? White guys been doing it. As soon as the brothers start doing it, that's when they got a problem. Like, come on, ladies, come on. Leave us alone. Let the brothers go find their love, okay? You stay here, you deal whatever you got here, and the brothers gonna go find their loves, okay? All right.
How many Filipino girlfriends did you have?
Many.
Many?
The problem is all she cared about was taking care of me, and I don't need somebody that does that.
Oh.
All she was worried about all the time is how I am and what I'm doing. Everything I do, let me do that.
My man said she's doing too much.
Too much.
She's taking care of me too well.
How many Filipino girls?
I wouldn't mind that. I want someone to take care of me.
So I want to know who out there can actually prove that these foreigners don't like Americans. Because Floyd and I went to the beach. And this is what we saw. We couldn't even just go to the beach. But I'm going to let you watch and see how foreigners here in the Philippines look at us. This isn't the first time this happened or the first country.
Hey, hey. Passport Bros.
So I want to know who.
And I'm looking forward to the challenge.
Sentence of death in China? How'd homie get sentenced to death? What did he do?
Chinese court sentences U.S. citizen to death for murder. Beijing, Reuters. A Chinese court sentenced U.S. citizen Shadid Abdulmateen to death on Thursday for intentional homicide of a 21-year-old.
Jeez. Wow. So, I don't know. That guy's just a murderer. That guy doesn't really have anything to do with the passport, bros. I gotta say that, like, for real. That's just a murder. At the end of the day, he got what he deserved, okay? Okay, let's move on next.
As a place where men are doing this and they're going there and they're finding success, or is it just that there's a lot of women there that are looking to marry? Like, what is it about the Philippines?
Hmm. Well, it's a lot of factors. Mm-hmm. So the first factor, which is huge, is the fact that
they speak English.
Filipino woman
speaks
English.
That's good.
Okay, so you don't have the language barrier.
Exactly. The second one is the fact that there are a lot of American and Western men that are already living there that have found Filipino wives.
So, no, it works. It works.
And because it's a developing country, the cost of living there is extremely inexpensive.
As a place where
men- And that is true. The cost of living in the Philippines is really, like, it's low for foreigners, people, for foreigners is low. And once you have something like online, like an online business or some kind of income, constant income, the Philippines is like a great place to go live, man. I'm telling you, it's beautiful. People are welcoming, and I can't say anything bad about the Philippines. All right. So far, I spent a couple months there in the Philippines, and I will tell you, it's great. All right. It's honestly great.
If you're wondering why the Passport Bros movement exists, watch this.
The Passport Bro movement in America exists because men in America, they lack motivation.
Oh, God.
They're mediocre. And women in America have to work. They get educated and they start making money because they have to. So why would American women have to put up with a man that don't have any of those qualities?
Okay.
This passport.
This is why you're gonna end up being lonely.
To another country and offer this woman, and he says it in the video that if he goes to the Philippines and he offers a woman a better life, he said it right there. He's just basically manipulating these women into thinking that they're gonna have a better life with them, which they might because they may live in very poor areas.
Oh my God! See what I mean? Just watching this lady is pissing me off so far. Because they always assume it's because they're poor or they want better lives, and that's not the truth. Maybe they just want to know how to treat their men. That's it.
You bring her to America, that's expensive. You're going to have to work your ass off. You're going to have to be the provider. You're going to have to...
I'm pretty sure she can take care of herself.
If she doesn't have an education, you might even have to pay for her education, and she might end up leaving you. Because life here is different, and you can't expect women in America to be like the women in other countries. You can't expect women here in America to go for a guy that's below them. If I go to school, I make six figures.
This is how you become lonely, though. More.
Because men in America, they want their women to go 50-50 on the bills and 50-50 maybe on the household and the chores, which usually is more like 90-10. So why would a woman here settle for some loser? We have high expectations because we can. I literally just saw a video of a guy that is stranded in the Dominican
Republic. Oh, I seen that one too.
He's broke and he's asking people to cash app him money for his ticket back to the U.S. Because this man, they're broke in America and they go to another country where the value of the dollar is a lot higher, and they lie to these women and they pretend that they're wealthy men.
When they're not.
So they are gaslighting this woman into thinking that they're going to come here and they're going to have this great life. Just stop lying to women. It doesn't matter if they're from another country. They are women. They have expectations and you're lying to them. And you know what? Most quality men in America, they have no problem finding women here.
I kind of agree with some of the things she says, but the problem is when these women start making too much money, it becomes very difficult for them to find a man, because they always, like she said, she won't marry or find someone that makes less money than her. And then she ends up being very lonely when she gets older, because she doesn't want to be a loser or anyone who doesn't have as much money as her. And that's the problem. They don't think about the family anymore. They just base their thing on, like, I want to make as much money as possible, and that's it. That's all they care about, making as much money as possible, and they don't care about their family, care about staying at home and taking care of the kids, care about taking care of the house, and they don't treat the man like king. And then they wonder why men go out there and, like, continue to cheat or do other things, because, or want to go other places looking for, go other places looking for women. This is the reason, like, women like that. That's one of the reasons why. All right, so anyways, that's it. I'm out. Bye.